men are out here killing one another senselessly. Last year in 2012, in Chicago, Illinois, 532 black men lost their lives in the streets of Chicago, Illinois. When the United States reported that only 351 soldiers lost their lives in the Sunni triangle over in the Middle East, yet and still, 532 black men in the city of Chicago lost their lives in the street. 7,500 black men last year lost their lives in the streets of America. You can't tell me that America ain't a damn hellhole.
Right.
Black men killing one another. Black women having over 350,000 abortions a year. 80% of abortion clinics in the black community. Over 1.3 million black men locked down in a white man's penitentiary and jail system.
Right.
And you trying to tell me how great America is? America is a hellhole, black man. And your mind is twisted to sit up here and call America a great country when yet and still you the last hired and the first fired.
Right.
When you still got to sit up here and watch all these immigrants and foreigners come to this country, and yet still the federal government give them millions of dollars to set up businesses right here in the ghetto, and yet still you can't even get a dollar to set up your own business. Nowadays, you gotta go out here and beg the Asian man for a damn job. And you sitting up here trying to call America this great country when every race of people in this country look at your people as spit. They don't even respect black people.
Right.
Matter of fact, some of us and the brothers, we was having a conversation last night, and it's true. The Ishmaelites, which are the Middle Eastern people, they came out and said, well, you want to know the reason why we don't sit up here and kidnap black soldiers? You want to know the reason why, brother? Because they don't see us as any value. But you remember when Jessica Lynch, the little white girl, she balled up around her weapon and started crying when the war first kicked off. What did the white man do? He sent all types of planes and tanks and Navy SEALs and all types of special forces to go in over into the Middle East and to get that white girl.
That's right.
That's how they look at us. But you niggas want to sit up here and call America this great country. And you wonder why we killing each other in the street. You wonder why young black women growing up to be whores and they sleeping with every Tom, Dick, and Harry in the street. The reason is because we got away from what thus saved the Most High. That's the reason why. You want to know why black men can't get any respect? Why black men don't even have the authority over their own household?
Right.
They don't even have the authority over their wives. Don't even have the authority to say who their daughters can and can't marry. It's because we gotten away from what thus saith the Most High.
The scripture.
It's in the book. Just like you can sit right now at that red light. You obey the white man's law, but then you don't want to come out here and obey the Most High's law. But tomorrow, a lot of you simple Negroes gonna get up and run right into these damn churches. So-called Negroes gonna get up and run right into these damn churches and sit up here and let these preachers lie to you and tell you that the Old Testament, it don't really matter. When the Most High said heaven and earth shall pass, but what's gonna stand? The scripture gonna stand. That's what's gonna get you. That's what's gonna see you through to the end. Go ahead, give me the Apocrypha, Baruch chapter 4, verse 1.
Baruch chapter 4, verse 1. This is the book of the commandments of the Most High.
This is a book of a good faith.
Book of the commandments of the Most High.
This is a book of good nursery rhyme.
Book of the commandments of the Most High. And the law that endureth forever.
And the what endureth forever?
The law that endureth forever.
Hold on, wait a minute. What do they teach you up in these Christian churches Sunday morning? They teach you that the law is done away with. But why is the prophets of the Most High saying the law endureth forever? Is it wrong to be a homosexual? Yes, it's wrong to be a homosexual. It was wrong 6,000 years ago. And guess what, black man, black woman? It's wrong today. Is it wrong for a black man to go out here and sleep with another black man's wife? Guess what, black man? It's wrong for you to sleep with another man's wife. Christ said in the Bible, he said it's, he took it one step further. He said it's wrong for you to even look at another man's wife as you would your own. And a lot of you brothers sit up here and listen to T.D. Jakes and brother right up the street, Bishop Blake, and all these false prophets that tell you that it's all right as long as you repent, have a repentative heart and sorrow. Yeah, and then like the brother just brought out, you all sit up here and watch basketball wives and look at them. All right, brother, that's right. Go ahead. Let's go to Book of Joshua, chapter 1, verse 8. Okay, finish with what you got.
All they that keep it shall come to life, but such as leave it shall die.
Con. It says, all that keep it shall come to life, but all that leave it shall die. Why do you think, black people, we out here dying in the streets of America? We can't get no justice. We left what thus saith the Most High. We left the scriptures. That's the reason why we killing ourselves in the streets of America. That's why the black man and the Hispanic man and the Native American man, that's why we the last hired in the first fire. That's why our Native American brothers, they got them brothers on concentration camps, but they call them reservations. But the real name is just a concentration camp filled with crack cocaine and alcoholism. We got in the way from the law. That's why we died. And what's going to bring us back to life is coming back to the scripture.